sedikit.
Hi.
Hi everybody.
Hi. Ini saya, Bapak-bapak, Ibu-ibu, rekan Miss Mira Ramani. Hi. So, sebagai seorang behavior analyst, tentu kita harus terus belajar ya dengan teknologi baru, teknik baru, metode baru dan juga perkembangan di bidang ABA dan juga autisme. Jadi seorang BCBA itu harus komplit menyelesaikan 32 jam training yang harus diakreditasi sama BACB. Jadi bukan sembarang training dalam 2 tahun. Jadi 2 tahun ini walaupun saya sudah BCBA, saya tetap harus belajar training selama 32 jam. Dan mungkin seorang behavior analis perlu seseorang yang akan memberikan arahan dari orang yang lebih pengalaman. Jadi salah satunya saya kenalkan my mentor Miss Mira Ramani.
Hai
Miss Mira. Miss Mira ini adalah founder dan juga program director dari Behavior Enrichment Dubai. Jadi salah satu training center, early learning center di Dubai. Dia beliau ini membawa ABA untuk klien yang membutuhkan, dan juga Miss Mira ini sangat pengalaman lebih dari 25 tahun di bidang sebagai psikolog dan juga bidang mental health ya, dan salah satu BCBA pertama di Dubai. Udah pengalaman banget nih. Wow, yeah. Yeah. A lot of experience, right?
Yeah.
So, more than 25 years.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. Dan beliau ini juga sudah lebih bekerja dari 2000 anak dan orang tua, terapis dan konsultan. Jadi benar-benar sudah pengalaman. Di bawah Miss Mira sudah mentori 30 RBT. RBT itu salah satu credential dari BCBA. BCABA, BCBA itu level S1 dan BCBA. Yang programnya ada di Dubai, di UAE ya, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, Sharjah, Ajman, dan segalanya. Sebelumnya beliau adalah Kepala Autis Department dan Parentary Outreach Center, itu adalah salah satu center specialty di Dubai. Dan beliau juga seorang BCBA dan Master Bidang Education. Oke, sekarang saya mau tanya sebetulnya ABA itu apa, VB itu apa, dan bagaimana ABA dan VB bisa membantu. So, Miss Mira, we want to talk like about what is ABA, what is VB, and how can this technique can help kids with autism, or people with autism to get a better life or something like that.
Yes.
Okay, so can you please explain to us, to the listening audience too, like what is ABA actually?
AD is a science. So science means every day there is new treatment. So this program of ABA, which is always going to be, you know, you're looking forward to getting more and more things going to come in this with research.
Okay.
So basically ABA is a science, it's an evidence-based treatment, and it's measuring your behavior, observable behavior, and bringing in changes in the child's life every day. So it's a very data-driven program, and it's a wonderful science example to be working with. It really works with our kids with autism. Yes.
Okay, that's good. So like we have still misconceptions for some people, like especially maybe back in my country, like this method, because it's like something is like it's robotic, something like you have to do see all things about tabletop, like you have to do this, you just like pick the card and you just like, you know, like. There are a lot of misconception. Actually, it's not only in Indonesia, but maybe around the world. So maybe can you explain to us and how it works actually ABA?
Yeah, actually ABA, as I said, like Ruri has told, it's driven. A BCBA is a main consultant who designs a program. An ABA programs could be fun if the right person, you know, conducts it or does the intervention. As you can see, lots of toys, lots of fun for children to learn, and it's a very play way method. Initially, it's like a balance. If the child is pairing with the instructor pairs with the child, and then we start putting demands. So no way it is robotic. It can be fun. It all depends on the therapist. If the therapist knows how to conduct a good ABA program, it can be really fun and the child is motivated to learn and retain. Like we've been telling Ruri, 80% of the time we do maintain the program and add 20% new program.
Yes.
So ABA programs are very can be quite vast. You can build in play skills in that, you can build in educational goals in that, you can take it to anywhere. I think we are doing a lot of research on it. I mean, I have got children who are in a regular school still following ABA programs.
See?
So that's how it is.
Yeah. So that's maybe there's some misconception from people that like mislead, like ABA is only like DTT, like pointing the pictures, pointing the cards. It's more than that.
No, this is not. I think Ruri will show you also some videos of our ABA program being conducted. Yes. It's quite, it can be quite natural. You can do it on the tabletop. You can do it outside the table. You can mix both and do it. You can do it in the playground. You can do it in a classroom. You can do it in a mall or anywhere you go.
Okay, that's good.
Yes, yes. Semoga bisa memberikan penjelasan kepada Bapak Ibu semua mengenai ABA dan bagaimana ini sebetulnya adalah benar-benar treatment yang sangat evidence based. Is all about data.
It's all about data. It's all about data driven. Everything is recorded, so parents have evidence of the treatment. Mm-hmm. That's why it's called evidence based.
Yes.
And we have about 150 students. Mm-hmm. You can ask any of our parents how they have improved, their children have improved, and many can give you interviews on that. It's
right.
Like it has made changes in their life.
Yes, yes, yes. Betul, itu betul banget tuh. Terus kemudian, I want to ask, like, what is the connection between ABA and autism? How it became like...
See, the reason why ABA is very powerful with children with autism is many of our children do not have certain, I mean, skills such as waiting. They do not have the behavior component, actually. The behavior means sitting tolerance, not waiting, not transitioning from one activity. Because of this inflexible behavior, which becomes a challenge for learning, ABA works a lot with autism than any other things. Because you are looking at how to change the behavior from inflexibility to flexible, being flexible, being adapting to changes, adapting to tolerance.
Yes.
So that is what is the main thing in ABA, which it works for children with autism.
Okay.
And since our children, they learn more through direct teaching than through a regular in a big group or something. At times you have to do this 1:1 direct teaching for them to learn.
Okay.
But gradually you have to take it to generalization for sure. Yeah.
Ya, jadi begitulah koneksinya. Bagaimana ABA bisa membantu people with autism,
Yes.
Gimana
yes.
mereka bisa mempelajari skills baru dan juga like learning the new skills and also like reduce the problem behavior,
yes.
right?
Yes.
Okay. So, how is actually the ABA around the world? I mean, how is it progressing, especially in autism field?
Yeah. So every year we go and present our research paper in the US. We take part in one of the major conferences, and that is that happens in America.
Yes.
And ABA is a big, as I said, it's a science. So you have many branches which has come to regular schools too. Mm-hmm. Like within ABA, you have verbal behavior, you have precision teaching, you have discrete trial teaching.
Yes.
The teaching itself can be, if you branch out to so many things.
Yeah.
So you have the pivotal response training. So everything comes under a big umbrella of ABA.
Yes.
So ABA is just not a treatment for autism. That's a big misconception. ABA can also be used to treat any other kid. It's just simply good teaching. That's it.
Yeah, betul. Jadi kalau ada yang nanya, kemudian ada yang beberapa tanya di website saya atas anak dengan misalnya dengan keterlambatan yang lain, bisa nggak dibantu dengan ABA? Sebetulnya bisa.
Yes.
Kan ada normal typical kid.
Because ABA believes in breaking up and teaching. That means you can teach anything by breaking it into minute parts. That's what is ABA. Simply good teaching. That's
yes, it's a very powerful,
very powerful, very scientific, and with positive behavior support for kids, so they enjoy having fun, having playing with their toys, learning.
Okay, thank you for explaining. And how about the trend of ABA around the world, I mean, especially for the kids with autism? Like,
it's very well. As I said, American Psychological Association, the pediatric. It is also covered by insurance in the states.
Yes.
Imagine that.
Yeah.
I think 47 states are covered by insurance for ABA. That could always say the ABA is very powerful.
Yes.
And within our this thing, there are about 20% of our families get coverage for insurance.
So moga-moga di Indonesia ilmunya bisa cepat lebih berkembang sekarang ya. Because now Indonesia we don't cover ABA, but maybe in the future.
Hopefully. Like I'm from India, and in India they started covering insurance for behavior therapy, and I think they have certain coverage amount for a year.
Yeah,
so imagine the ABA's reach there also in all was pockets.
Okay. Nah, sekarang kita bicara tentang setelah ABA secara global, kita mau bicara tentang sebenarnya feudal behavior. So we're talking about feudal behavior, how the feudal behavior is a part of ABA.
It's a feudal behavior, a part of ABA.
Yes.
Here you are working on the different verbal operants, which make it a whole for the language to build in. So we are not really going into the structural component of language. We're going into the functional units of language, like Skinner said. He has divided the whole language into functional units, and we teach verbal behavior for the children to learn the language in that way, because most of our children learn language with association. So in verbal behavior program, we teach each of the unit, like for example, if you have a cookie, at times a child may not be able to ask for a cookie, but he may be able to label a cookie. Like you ask him, what is this? He might say cookie. But when he wants cookie, he may not exactly be able to ask for cookie, because you are asking him, what do you want? And he simply cannot process the language there. So what do you want and what is this has got some change in language. Yeah. So our children learn to process all these through the ABA programs, because they work on different components of the verbal behavior program.
Yes. Yeah. So like some people, like some many kids have autism, like it's verbal, like they can talk but they cannot like has the two conversations and all
that. Correct. So we do lead, if there is a good ABA program given, it can lead you to reciprocation, conversation. It depends on how the program is.
Yes.
Like we always put a lot of challenging program for our kids as they develop. At times we wonder like problem solving skills, because as the ABA program gets advanced, they go into more social programs. So that it becomes like a pragmatic program, pragmatic social language building up. So eventually conversation comes in.
Ya, so jadi nggak benar cuma tunjuk-tunjuk kartu, ini apa, itu apa, dan bagaimana, tetapi akan kalau memang sudah saatnya tepat, they're going to, like when they have the level, like certain level, they can like do a social
after the meeting part. After 3, they go for social skill program, so we follow a very good social skill program, that is also for 3 levels, and we take them to each level and where they can do conversation a lot.
Yes. Can you explain a bit about Freebie Map?
Vivi Map has got 3 levels. The first level is from 0 to 18 months. That is of a typical development, and they have done this Vivi Map by Sandberg has done it after 30 years of good research. So what they have done is they have compared it with neurotypical children growing up. How a 0 to 18 month old child should have how much language. 18 to 30 month old should have how much language.
Yes.
And the domains differ from each. Like the first domains will have only 9. The level 1, then there is level 2, that is till 30 months, and then there is level 3, till 48 months. We'll explain once more, maybe we'll
So just give guidance
for the kids. With a map, you can show one of our child.
Yes. Maybe next, mungkin lain kali nanti kita bisa bahas lebih lanjut tentang Freebie Map, tapi paling tidak ini memberikan gambaran bahwa ada tools, ada assessment tool yang memang bisa menggambarkan.
This is one of the assessment tools, which is proven to be effective for any kid with under the spectrum. Okay, but then as we do have many other tools which are developed, but they are not so much criterion based as this one.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So what is actually the advantage of PB compared to other like?
The ABLEs are in the VB map have stayed here for longer time than any other thing. There are so many other programs which have come in, but they have not lasted so much because of the, the graphing, the measurability makes a big difference.
Okay, thank you. And then that's maybe this is the things that parents want to know, like in like they have 5 symptoms and their kids, and then kira-kira kalau ada orang tua yang belum bisa anaknya belum bisa ngomong atau bisa konversasi atau kelihatan different gitu ya, itu harus bagaimana dan kira-kira umur berapa mulainya? So, jadi saya akan tanya ya. Jadi Miss Mira, so like if parents want to have feelings that his their children like you know like do something like weird or like they don't talk when while they're like 2 years plus, and then what should they do?
They should immediately start with a good ABA program under supervision of a BCBA. The reason is if you wait more, the delay sets in. Initially the delay is less, but as the age grows, the delay might be more. So don't wait for anything. Don't have any social stigma. Please rush and get your treatment. Your child can do well in life if you start early.
So how old is actually the best?
As early as 2 years. It's not more than that. I mean, if you can, of course, do it at 5 and 6, but if you get a child who's not paying joint attention, start as early as 2 years. Yes. Yeah. Early intervention is the best because child is really compliant and listens to instructions. Yes.
Yeah, jadi kita nggak harus nunggu sampai umurnya 3 tahun because there's so many people like thinking like, especially for boys, if they don't talk like before 3, they just talk a little bit, they say like, no. It's okay because it's boy. So it's not correct. Yeah? We don't need to wait. We don't need
a good effective program. You can go to a higher level where your child will function in a regular school. So don't hesitate on that. That's what I'm saying. Start as early as possible and work on it.
So just can you show, give us like a little bit of symptoms that what is there we have, that the parents have to consider?
See, most of the symptoms would be eye contact, joint attention, the child not responding to your voice. When you call him, there are 6 to 7 flags which you can say, red flags. You can also go and check with N-Chat. There's N-Chat freely available in the internet. You can go and check if you get 6 scores and above or something. You will have to be a bit cautious of that, like where do you get the flags, and there's no eye contact, if there is no name call response, if the child does not, doesn't have voice. And if he doesn't give a social smile, these could be indicators for under the spectrum. Or if the child is too hyperactive, or you find some tantrums which are a little unusual, could also be a concern.
So actually, what is that like you can pinpoint this problem? Like maybe like a
get a provisional diagnosis as a second, but we don't give a real diagnosis to the age of 4. But a provisional diagnosis always given and the treatment plan should be started. But the age of 2 itself we can make out. Some children we have are as early as 1 year and 8 months also.
Because
they don't see the symptoms. The parents themselves are doctors, so they don't want to wait.
Okay, thank you very much Miss Mira. So untuk hari ini cukup sekian, dan mungkin kalau ada yang pertanyaan nanti mungkin minggu depan silakan nanti ditulis di bawah, nanti Miss Mira akan menjawabnya pada minggu depan. Fadil, terima kasih. Thank you very much Miss Mira.
Most welcome. And Rudy is a part of us. She's a part of our family now. So anything for everybody, I'm ready to.
Okay, thank you very much.
Welcome.
Bye.